Now we're going to take a look at how to solve linear systems of equations, but now we're going to use the combination method or the elimination method. The first thing is that when we do combination, the goal is to combine the equations so that one of the variables will be eliminated. Well, right now all I'm going to look at is the part of combining the equations. And let's say you have a balance scale. And on the left side you have x, and on the right side you have 5, and it's balanced. Well, then we're going to have a second balance scale. Now, if our balance scales are balanced, that indicates that t is equal to 12 and that our x is equal to 5. So now, if I want to combine these two things, what I can do is I can combine one side of the balance scale with the one side of the other balance scale. So I could add these two equations together. I could take my x plus t, and that would be ha have to be equal to this side of the balance scale. So think of it as if I want to take these two separate scales and put them on their own balance scale, I could put the x box and the t box on this side, and I know that that would have to balance out with the 5 plus the 12, which gives me a 17 here. So this is the idea of what combination is. We are going to be combining equations using addition, and what we're going to do is we're going to manipulate them first so that one of the variables will be eliminated, but this is how we combine them, and this is why combination works, is because if I have two equal parts and then I add two other equal parts to them, they stay equal. We also see this in the additive property of equality. If I had x was equal to 10, and I want to add 2 to the left side, I can also add 2 to the right side and still maintain equality because I'm adding equal amounts. Well, up here with my x equals 5, I added t and I added 12 because those are equal amounts. So now here's how combination is going to work. The first thing I have to do is I have to have my two equations and I have to set them up so that the x's are all in a column and the y's are all in a column. Equal signs have to be in a column, and then my constant number has to be in a column. Second thing I have to check for is I have to check for coefficients that are the same but opposite signs with the same variable. And so I've made this one so that my x's have the same coefficient with opposite signs. So I have a 2 and I have a negative 2. And they're both with my x. When that happens, now I'm going to add. So I'm going to take 2x plus a negative 2x, which gives me 0x. I'm going to take 4y minus 8y, which gives me negative 4y. And then 12 plus a negative 10 is going to give me 2. So I end up getting negative 4y is equal to 2. Divide both sides by negative 4, and I get y is equal to negative 1/2. Now this is only part of my answer. Again, I have an x, y for each equation, so I need to take this, plug it back into one of my equations. Doesn't matter which equation you plug it back into. I'm gonna plug it back into the top, so I would have 2x plus 4 times negative 1/2 is equal to 12. And then I can go ahead and I can solve this to figure out what my x value is. So now I have my xy pair. I should have my solution is 7 negative 1/2. I do need to check this though. So since I had used the top equation to find my 7, I'm going to plug my solution into the bottom equation and see if it works. So I would have negative 2 times 7 minus 8 times negative 1/2. And hopefully that'll equal negative 10. So I end up with negative 14 plus 4, and I get negative 10 equals negative 10. So it does work. So 7 comma 1/2 is my solution, that ordered pair. Now here's an example. I've got my y's lined up, I've got my x's, my equals, and my constants lined up. But in this case, I don't have the same and opposite coefficients anywhere. The 4 and the 2 and the 7. Now the 2x and the 2y are the same number, but because they're not on the same variable, I can't actually go and combine those two together. So what you have to do is you have to decide, well, what's it going to be easier to get to be the same number but opposite? So is it going to be easy to change my 2 into a 4 or to change my 2 into a 7? Well, I can change my 2 into a 4 by multiplying. I can change my 2 into a 4 by multiplying by 2. And I can change it into opposite by multiplying by negative 2. So I have to distribute this negative 2 to everything in my bottom equation, because on my balance scale, it has to be distributed to both sides to maintain equality. So I'm going to end up with negative 4y plus negative 14x equals negative 30. So I have the exact same equation, just rewritten. I had to multiply it by negative 2, so that way I could get my 4 and my negative 4. Once I have that, then I'm going to add. So my 4y plus a negative 4y is 0y. My 2x plus a negative 14x is negative 12x. And then 20 plus negative 30 is negative 10. Now notice this method is called the combination method or the elimination method. This portion right here is why it's called the elimination method. Because when I get these coefficients to be the same number but opposites, I am eliminating a variable, because then all of a sudden I have zero y's. So I combine my equations in order to eliminate one of my variables. Then I can solve it out and I get x is equal to 10 twelfths. Now I have to go back and I have to plug that back in. So I'm going to use the top equation, and I would have my 4y plus 2 times 10 twelfths is equal to 20. I can solve that out. Now remember, in order to subtract, I have to subtract this 20 twelfths from the 20. I have to get a common denominator. Well, my common denominator is going to be 12, so I need to multiply the top by 12 and the bottom by 12 in order to change my 20 over 1 into a denominator of 12. So I would end up with 240 over 12. And now that they have a common denominator, I can just subtract across the tops. So I would have 220 over 12. I'm going to go ahead and reduce that by 4 and get 55 over 3. So I'm at the point where 4y equals 55 over 3. I need to divide by 4, but when I'm dividing fractions, I actually multiply by the reciprocal, so it would be 55 over 3 times 1/4, which gives me y is equal to 55 over 12. So now I have my solution, 10 over 12, comma 55 over 12, that ordered pair, and I need to check it. This might be another one of those situations where it's easier to just use your calculator to check it, since I got kind of strange fractions. So I would go back up to my original equation and I would plug it back in to check it. And when I do that workout, I get 15 is equal to 15. So the 10 twelfths comma 55 twelfths is my solution. All right, on this problem, there's several things that I have to do. First of all, I need to make sure that my x's and my y's actually line up. So I'm going to go ahead and rearrange my top equation here so that my 4x is underneath my 3 and that my 7y is underneath my 2y. Now it's going to be 4x plus 7y, not because of that symbol right here, but because the symbol in front of the 7 is positive. So that indicates that it has to be a positive 7y. And then I'm going to bring my minus 10 down. Then I'm going to look for some compatible numbers. Well, 3 and 4 aren't really all that compatible, but 2 and 7 aren't that compatible either. So I'm going to have to multiply both equations by a number in order to get them to be the same number but different signs. And I'm going to go ahead and work with my 3 and my 4. So I'm going to have to multiply the top equation by 4 in order to get that to be a 12, and I'm going to have to multiply my bottom equation by 3 in order to get that to be a 12. Now, the negative portion of what I need is already taken care of, because I have a negative 3 right here and a positive 4 right here. So when I multiply these out, I'm going to go ahead and distribute that 4 to everything inside there, so it would be negative 12x plus 8y equals negative 28. And then across the bottom, distribute that 3 out, and I'm going to get 12x plus 21y equals negative 30. Now I have the same number but opposite signs, so I can go ahead and add my equations. So I'm going to have 0x, there's the eliminated part, plus 29y is equal to negative 58. So the 0x is gone. I need to divide both sides by 29, so I have y is equal to negative 58 divided by 29. Well, that is actually y is equal to negative 2. Now I need to go back and I need to plug it in. I'm going to plug it into the negative 3x plus 2y equation. So I have negative 3x plus 2 times negative 2 is equal to negative 7. When I solve that out, I am going to end up with negative 3x is equal to negative 3. Divide both sides by negative 3 and I get x is equal to 1. So I've got my ordered pair of 1, comma, negative 2. I still do need to check that though. I need to check that in my other equation, my 4x plus 7y. So I'm going to put in there my 4 times 1 plus 7 times negative 2 is equal to negative 10. And I get 4 plus negative 14 equals negative 10. And negative 10 equals negative 10. So it does work. So my solution for this particular one was 1, negative 2. Okay, here's your first practice problem. Go ahead, pause the video, and use the combination method to solve this particular system. Should have gotten the point 0 comma 5 thirds. So the first thing I did was I chose to get the y's to be the same. You could have picked the x's to be the same. And for me to get the y's to be the same, I had to multiply by negative 2 because I needed to get the 3 to be a 6, but I also needed it to be a negative 6. Distributed that out and got negative 6y plus negative 4x equals negative 10. Combined those, and I ended up with negative 3x equals 0. Divide both sides by negative 3, and I got x is 0. Came over here, and I plugged it back in to get my y, and then I checked it. Okay, here's another practice problem. Again, use the combination elimination method to solve the system. So go ahead and pause the video and see what you come up with. Okay, this one might have turned out a little strange. I chose to get the x's to be the same, so I multiplied the top equation by negative 2 and got negative 6x plus 2y equals negative 18. Then I added my equations together, and when that happened, my x's were eliminated, my y's were eliminated, so I had 0x plus 0y, which is just 0, and negative 18 plus 18 is 0. So I ended up with 0 equals 0. I have no variables left. This is going to happen sometimes, and when this happens, we have a special situation. What you have to look at is this statement always true or always false? When this happens, since this is always true, you are going to have an infinite number of solutions. So I can pick whatever value I want for x, and when I solve it out in the top equation, I'll get my y. Well, that'll be the exact same pair that would fit into my bottom equation. If you end up with 10 equals 10, the same thing happens because that is always true. It could be negative 1 half equals negative 1 half. All of these lead to an infinite number of solutions because they have no variables and the statement is true. Now sometimes you're going to go through and you're going to do the work and you're going to end up getting something like 5 is equal to 7. Similar, because I have no variables here, but the problem is that this statement is always false. I'm never going to get 5 to equal 7. So when it's a false statement, instead of an infinite number of solutions, it's actually a no solution. What we have would be two parallel lines that don't ever touch. So if you end up with a statement that has no variables in it and is false, it's going to be a no solution. If you end up with a statement that is true and has no variables in it, then it's going to be an infinite number of solutions. Those are the two special cases that we run into once in a while. Most of the time you're actually going to have an ordered pair for an answer, but there are occasions where we can end up with either of these two situations.